In this video, I want to go through and show you how to configure and install IntelliJ IDEA, the community edition, for a Mac platform. Now, if you're running Windows or a Linux machine, refer to the videos that I've got for those operating systems on this channel. But if you're on a Mac, I should say, and ready to install IntelliJ IDEA, let's get started. Alright, so in this video, we're going to install and configure IntelliJ for the Mac. The first thing we want to do now is go to JetBrains.com. Now, JetBrains is the company that have created the IntelliJ IDEA product, which we'll be using to write Java programs. Once you get to their site, navigate over to Tools, and just hover over that. Come down here to IntelliJ IDEA, click on that. And then come down here and select download. I'm just going to close this little cookie window by clicking on yes, I agree. So this is what we do there. Now we've got two options for IntelliJ once we get to the screen. We can download the Community Edition or the Ultimate Edition. And you can see that the Community Edition is free and open source. So that would be the best option for you if you don't want to pay for the software. The Ultimate Edition is set up if you're a professional programmer and you need access to some of the other features. So for now, I suggest you download the Community Edition, and I'm going to start that download. And you can see it's downloading up here. And in terms of the Ultimate Edition, you do get a trial. You get a 30-day trial with that. But as I mentioned earlier, the Community Edition will do everything you want it to do, and there's really no need to get the Ultimate Edition unless you specifically want to access some of the features as a professional programmer would. All right, so you can see at this point now, IntelliJ Community Edition has downloaded for me. I'm going to open it. I'm going to navigate to the folder. I'm going to double click to open it. And I'm going to close down the browser because we're done with that now. Close down Finder. And you can see, being a Mac application, it's quite easy to install. We're just going to drag it into the Applications folder. We'll give that a moment to complete. So you can see it there completing on the screen. That's now complete. So I'm going to close that window, and I'm going to close this here. I'm going to eject it. And the other thing I'll do then is start it. So I'm just going to open a Finder window. I'm going to go to my Applications. And we'll find IntelliJ IDEA CE, CE standing for Community Edition. I'm going to double click that and we'll open it up. We'll give that a moment to verify. We'll click on Open. Now, the very first time that you open IntelliJ IDEA, either the first time ever on your computer or the first time for a new version, you'll get this little pop-up. And this gives you the option, if you've already got an installation of IntelliJ IDEA, you can select the location and download or import, rather, the settings from a previous installation. Now, we don't need to do that here for two reasons. Firstly, we haven't got any setting changes, but secondly, we haven't got a previous installation either. So I'm going to click on Do Not Import Settings. But that's an option for you. And in fact, if IntelliJ found in its previous installation of IntelliJ on the computer, it would actually come up with that directory automatically. But I'm going to select Do Not Import Settings and click on OK. You may or may not get this option here for privacy policy, depending where you are in the world. So I'm just going to scroll down to the bottom and click on Accept. But you can read that and do whatever is appropriate. Likewise, for data sharing, you may or may not get this, but if you do get it, I would suggest don't send, but you can send anonymous usage statistics to JetBrains to help improve their software if you want. I'm going to click on don't send. So now we've got a couple of configuration options. You can choose the background. I'm going to go with a light background like so, but if you want to choose darkula, you can do that. And you can change any of these settings that I'm showing you in these settings at a later point. So don't think that you can't change it down the track. You can do that if you want to. I'm going to click on Next. I'm going to leave the default key map scheme. If you know what you're doing and you want to change things, you can do that. But I'm going to leave the default, and that's what I'll assume, that you're using the default key map settings. I'm going to click on Launch a Script. Now, this is an option if you want to run IntelliJ IDEA from the command line. Now, we won't be doing that. We'll just be invoking IntelliJ by starting the icon, double-clicking the icon as we normally would. But it won't hurt to create the launcher script if you want to do that. You can click on that. It's there if you need to. And it's just a shortcut if you're a programmer who uses the command line. I'm going to click on next, and it's been created for us. IntelliJ IDEA gives you the option to download and install plugins, and you can see there's a variety there. But all these ones on the screen we aren't going to use, but you can see that in fact some of them are actually set. In fact, all of them are set to be installed anyway. So we're just going to leave them as they are. We're not going to change anything, and click on next, featured plugins. And these options here, we aren't going to install any of those because we're not going to be using these particular plugins. So I'm going to click on start using IntelliJ IDEA. Okay, we now, depending on whether you selected the launcher script or not, you'll be asked to enter your password. So I'm going to type that in. And IntelliJ IDEA is starting, as you can see. All right, so we've now got IntelliJ IDEA installed. But there are a couple of other things we want to do to get it ready to start using it. So the first thing we want to do is we want to connect or associate IntelliJ IDEA with the Java development kit we downloaded and installed in the previous video. So to do that, I'm going to select Configure. I'm going to come down here and select Project Defaults. Then I'm going to select Project Structure. I want to make sure that when this pops up, that Project is selected. And you can see that was selected by default for me. Now, this is the first time that we've installed IntelliJ on this computer. We've got here an option that says no SDK. Now, if I select that, you'll find that it may or may not have picked up that there's a Java 11 installation. In my case, even though I haven't actually configured IntelliJ on this computer before, it's actually found the installation for us automatically. So I can just click on that. And I could do it that way. I could configure it. But what I'm actually going to do is come down here to SDKs. And I'm going to delete this. And the reason I'm going to delete it is just to show you how to configure it if for some reason that wasn't selected. So if it is there, you can leave it as it was showing. Or you can see now that it no longer exists. We can click on New. We can select JDK. And you can see in this case that automatically IntelliJ has found the installation of Java for us, the JDK. If I click here, you can see that it's found the location, and this is the location where the JDK was installed automatically for us. So that would be the folder you would need to navigate to if you're doing this manually, and for some reason it didn't pop up automatically. We've got the JDK 11 folder, contents and home. But again, IntelliJ, as you saw, found that for us automatically. I'm going to click on open. And you can see now we've got 11, Java version 11 showing there. The other thing we need to do is change this project language level. I'm going to click on here, and we also want to click on and make that 11 so that it is set to the same version of the Java development kit that we're going to be using. So I'm going to click on that. You'll get this pop up, and this is because it's relatively new. So I'm going to click on accept. That most likely will disappear after a while, that pop up. But click on accept if you see it, and then click on OK. All right, so at this point, we've now configured the Java development kit for IntelliJ so that we can use that to create Java programs. Now there's a couple of other settings which are optional but are highly recommended. So what I'm going to do is just configure those now and then we'll actually be done. So to get access to those settings, I'm going to click on Configure. I'm going to select Preferences. When that opens, I'm going to come over here and select Editor, clicking on the Disclosure Triangle. I'm going to come down to General, click on that, and then again click on the Disclosure Triangle. And I'm going to first select Auto Import. Now there's two checkboxes here we want to check. First one, add unambiguous imports on the fly. And the second, optimize imports on the fly for current project. Now I'll actually talk later about what these are for, but for now we're just going to configure this and set these settings up. And these settings will be applied for every new project we create. All right, so moving on, the next thing we want to select is appearance. I'm going to click on that. And you want to make sure that show line numbers is checked. And you can see here that that is checked. So we don't need to do anything there. Then last area we need to go into is code folding. So I'm going to click on that. And what we're going to do is deselect or uncheck a number of these checkboxes. Now the reason we're unchecking them is we don't want IntelliJ to try and hide any of our code. When you're a professional programmer, you'll find that you'll often want to hide aspects of the code that you're very familiar with. But when you're just starting out, it's a good idea to make sure none of that happens. So for that reason, I'm going to uncheck imports. I'm also going to uncheck one-line methods. I'm going to uncheck closures. And finally, I'm going to uncheck generic constructor and method parameters. So don't worry too much about what they mean. I'll talk more about that in later videos. The point here is that we're deselecting those so that we get access to all the code when we're writing our Java programs. So I'm going to click on OK to save those changes. And at this point, we're now done. All right, so thanks for watching. If you've got questions, leave a comment. If you're ready for the next programming specific video, click on the link up here in the top left-hand corner of your screen. To look at non-coding programming related questions, click on the link down the bottom left-hand corner of your screen. Feel free to subscribe by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you in another video.